Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to today's Holy Mass, especially any visitors. In today's Gospel, Jesus invites the disciples to turn aside into a quiet place and rest a while. Our weekly celebration of the Eucharist can be a time and a place in which we are able to rest from the cares of the past week and be renewed for the week ahead. Confident that the Lord will renew us with his word and his body, we prepare to celebrate the Eucharist. Our celebrant at this Mass is Father Jaime. Let us now have a moment's silence to prepare for this Eucharist, to welcome Jesus into our hearts through his words and his body. Please stand for the opening hymn.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we celebrate this Sunday, let us call to mind our sins, our iniquities, for us to be worthy for our sacred celebrations, and let us ask God's mercy, pardon, and blessings. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to the Father and to one another. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You heal the wounds of our sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us with the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
let us pray. Show favor, Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Woe to the shepherds who destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, says the Lord. Therefore, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, concerning the shepherds who shepherd my people. It is you who have scattered my flock and have driven them away, and you have not attended to them. So I will attend to you for your evil doings, says the Lord. Then I myself will gather the remnant of my flock out of the lands where I have driven them, and I will bring them back to their fold. I will raise up shepherds over them who will shepherd them, and they shall not fear any longer or be dismayed, nor shall any go missing, says the Lord. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up for David a righteous branch, and he shall reign as king and deal wisely, and shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In his days, Judah will be saved, and Israel will live in safety. And this is the name by which he shall be called: the Lord is our righteousness. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Now in Christ, you who were once far off have been brought near by the blood of Christ, for he is our peace. In his flesh, he has made both Jews and Gentiles into one, and has broken down the dividing wall, that is, the hostility between us. He has abolished the law with its commandments and ordinances, that he might create in himself one new humanity in the place of the two, thus making peace, and might reconcile both groups to God in one body through the cross, thus putting to death that hostility through it. So Christ Jesus came and proclaimed peace to you who were far off, and peace to those who were near. For through him, both of us have access in one spirit to the Father. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. The apostles returned from their mission. They gathered around Jesus and told him that they had done and taught. He said to them, "Come away to a deserted place all by yourselves and rest a while." For many were coming and going, and they had no leisure even to eat. And they went away in the boat to a deserted place by themselves. Now many saw them going and recognized them. And they hurried there on foot from all the towns and arrived ahead of them. As Jesus went ashore, he saw a great crowd. And he had compassion for them, because they were like sheep without a shepherd. And he began to teach them many things. The Gospel of the Lord. This might be the hardest Sunday for me. The 16th Sunday, we'll be reflecting about the charism of a good shepherd. The charism of a good shepherd that also shared and imparted to us as believers of Jesus. But shepherding is always have a challenge. We could hear it in the first reading, that how Prophet Jeremiah tell us that God was disappointed because at that time there were shepherds that is not tending their flock, but instead they scatter them. There were shepherds that instead of uniting the flock, they make them scattered, because they were only good for themselves. They were selfish shepherds at the time. And God was so disappointed and said, I will send a prophet, a shepherd that could tend and look after my flock. And the second reading also telling us that Jesus united the Jews and the pagans. In the presence of Jesus, as a good shepherd, unite all those very, they are a kind of enemy. So if we have that charism in us, our presence, our words would also be the uniting factors in the community, in the church, or even the society. Because we also hear in the gospel when the apostles came back after their mission, they were tired. And again, Jesus, the good shepherd, told them, care for them, time for you to rest and go to a deserted place. But the people knew that. They knew that they are going in that area. So they were there ahead of the apostles in Jesus Christ. But if we notice in the gospel, Jesus had compassion to these people, the multitude of people who really needs care, who really need a shepherd. So how about us at this time, my dear brothers and sisters? I remember of what Pope Francis said, the worst sickness in this present generation is the inability to love. It's not COVID, it's not many kinds of sickness, but the inability to love. If we have that charism as a shepherd, if we cannot love, we cannot care, how can we do that in our society? Even in social media, we could hear that it's against the charism of a good shepherd. So the question is, how can we be a good shepherd in our generations? I remember the story of a woman. After we give blessings in her birthday, after Mass, this lady approached me and with the tears in her eyes, held my hands tightly, and she said, thank you for your blessings. I cannot remember the last time I celebrate my birthday. Thank you for the blessings because I feel at home. My dear brothers and sisters, the charism of a good shepherd is to make people at home, is to make these people come back to their home, the home with the shepherding that God is there. You and me, we are an instrument to make these people at home in a very simple gestures. Our mission is to bring them back and feel at home, especially in our church. May God bless us. Amen. Please stand, we'll profess our faith. I believe in God. Prayers the faithful. The heart of Christ goes out to his flock on earth. In the name of the Good Shepherd, let us ask the Father to fulfill our special needs.
For Pope Francis and all the pastors of the church, that they may never let the flock of the Christ be scattered, but gather it together in his name. Let us pray to the Lord.
For those entrusted with passing on the doctrine of the Church, that they nourish us with truth and wisdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for the teachers of our children, that they may impart knowledge and truth with conviction and responsibility. Let us pray to the Lord.
For the removal of all barriers between peoples, that we may all be one, as Jesus prayed to his Father. Let us pray to the Lord.
For the continued improvement of health of our Holy Father, Pope Francis. Let us pray to the Lord.
For the souls of the faithful departed, that the blood of Christ may win them eternal life, especially our family and friends and all those who have no one to pray for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father of the flock, hear the prayers of your people gathered at the banquet you have prepared, ready to offer the sacrifice of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Let us pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, the sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy as you blessed the gifts of Abel, so that what it has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pleads of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery, and so with all the angels who praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, the church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. the Savior's command, and for me divine teaching, we dare to say. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but at the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace in unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer this either the sign of peace. Holy love of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. Graciously, be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our mass has been offered. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.